Join Edwin Frondozo on the Business Leadership Podcast every week for a unique program featuring insights and actionable items from the world's most successful business leaders. Hear firsthand the exclusive interviews and personal journeys on how today's transformational leaders made it to the top.
This is the Business Leadership Podcast, and I'm your host, Edwin Frondozo. Welcome. How are you doing today? I wanted to welcome you to this special episode. I wanted to take this opportunity to take a pause from my regular scheduled episodes of interviewing amazing business leaders, entrepreneurs, thought leaders, when they share their experiences, their journeys, to talk about a recent experience that I went through. I recently completed the Berlin Marathon. And for those who don't know how long a marathon is 26 miles, 42 kilometers. And it's something that I do to help me stay fit, to help me train, to help me eat well. Being an A-type person, I really find it helpful to sign up to races, sign up to marathons, to give me an end goal, to have something to work towards, and to keep me, I guess just to keep me honest. For those who may not know, the Berlin Marathon was not my first marathon. It was actually my fourth marathon that I was attempting to complete. Now, having said that, I've done three marathons and I did complete all three. The first one was the Toronto Marathon in 2011, the New York Marathon 2013, Chicago Marathon 2017. Now, the reason why I wanted to share this story is I had a moment during the marathon that changed my life. I had a moment of clarity. I had a moment of bliss. I had a moment of enlightenment. So before I get to that moment, I just wanted to rewind to back to 2017 when I last finished a marathon. It was the Chicago Marathon, and it was not an ideal situation. There was a heat warning. It was 23, 24 degrees, which is very hot to run a marathon. So it was a heat warning, and I literally basically died on that marathon. I was dehydrated. My legs were cramping. And not only that, the place where I had my wife and daughter meet me, I had sent them to the wrong spot. And this was around halfway through the marathon. So it changed my emotions. And from that point on, I was literally spent emotionally because I was upset at myself that I set them up at a wrong place. And my daughter at the time was one and a half. So I was imagining my wife having a difficult time with my daughter. So that changed the mood of me, of what I was doing. And the fact that it was super hot, it was sunny, it was a tough run. I barely finished the run. I mean, I celebrated. It's a celebration. It's a success to finish any marathon standing, getting past the finish line. But I do remember swearing off marathons. I couldn't walk, and literally, I couldn't imagine myself doing a marathon. So about 12 months later, a good friend of mine, Dave, we trained for the Chicago Marathon together. We both had bad times. We put ourselves into the Berlin Marathon lottery because his niece wanted to run, and she's a good runner. She's fast, and the only way for us to get in was to put ourselves in together. Now, before even doing that, I still hadn't imagined myself doing a marathon. I mean, this is fall 2018. It's been almost a year since I ran the Chicago Marathon, but I'm like, heck, what the heck not? I think my memory was gone. I don't remember all the pain. I don't remember all the struggles. I totally forgot the whole situation or my emotions. So I said, yeah, what the heck? Let's do it. Let's just get into it and let's see what happens. If we get in, then we'll train for it. And obviously we got in. I had enough time started imagining, started planning 2019. How am I going to run this marathon? How am I going to be my best self and run this? So I took it seriously. I joined a gym, started training well. I changed my eating habits and I was running well. I lost 15 pounds. I controlled everything that I can control in my life to ensure that I will do the best I can to achieve that personal best in Berlin. So here we are running the Berlin Marathon. I'm feeling good. I'm feeling ready. In my mind, I'm going to have the best race of my life. So here we are running. There's rain in the forecast and it starts raining halfway through my race again. Just like in Chicago, halfway through the race, I misled my wife and daughter. But this time, halfway through the race, it started to rain on me. It was about 10, 12 degrees in Berlin. So it was cool. It was cold. I was running well. I was on target to hit my goal of 4 hours. But at the 25K mark, another half hour, it started pouring. Now, my upper body started tensing. My neck started tensing. My hands were getting numb. If I rolled my shoulder, I could feel my nerves pinch and a shock of electricity go through my arms. Oh man, it was bad. And this point on, my emotions changed. I think I hit a pit of despair. I was in the pit of despair from the 25K mark. I was questioning my sanity. I was wondering, why do I put myself through this? I mean, I'm an entrepreneur. I do many things. I already put myself through emotional roller coaster just by my professional decision. So why do I even do this? I mean, it was bad. I was hating life. And then about an hour later, around the 35K mark, something happened. And you see, before I ran the race, I drew two things on my hands. One, on my left hand, I drew a happy face. And on my right hand, I drew a sine wave. The happy face was to remind me that just to be happy, to smile, to enjoy the moment, to live. The sine wave was a reminder to me that life has its ups and downs. When it's up, remember things will go down. And when it's down, remember things will go back up. Science tells us that. So I drew this to remind me. So here we are. I'm in the pit of despair. I'm hating life. I look down and something happened. Something's changed. I released myself from all expectations and almost immediately I felt a release. I started smiling, huge smiles. I started looking around and noticing 100% for the first time that, man, I'm running a marathon in Berlin, Germany. It was amazing. I finished the marathon. I was tired, but I was happy and I was celebrating. And later that night, which was my second win, I was walking normally. I was tired, yes, but my training that I did this year proved positively. I wasn't sore. I could walk up and downstairs, which is a big thing. I remember texting my wife. I'm like, babes, I could walk up and downstairs. This is huge. So the lessons that I take from this was I understood the goals that I had. I controlled my environment. I controlled everything that I needed to do up until the race, which was train, eat well, rest, prepare, do everything right. But what happened was I couldn't control my outside world, which was the rain. But I allowed myself, my emotions, to get affected by the rain, to really question my life, wondering what the heck was I doing? Why am I here? Why did I decide to do this? And it was a moment of enlightenment. A good friend of mine, Coppell, said, Edwin, you had a moment of enlightenment. You are blessed. God blessed you with this. Because everyone has a moment of enlightenment at least one time in their life. And that's usually right before they die, when they flash back through the best times of their life or the worst times. But Edwin, you were blessed with this wisdom, with this enlightenment, that you release all expectations. You don't have to be so hard on yourself and really enjoy the moment. So with that, I hope you all have an amazing day. Control what you can control and let go of all expectations. I'll see you all next time.
Thank you for listening to the Business Leadership Podcast at thebusinessleadership.com.